We'll get away with everything. We'll show them we are better.
We were staying in Paris to get away from your parents, and I thought, wow, if I could take this in a shot right now.
Hey guys, it's Mare. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about my new health and fitness kind of journey that I've been on for the past few months or so. And I did a video similar to this one last year. It was my New Year health and fitness for 2016 video, and I talked about, you know, being healthy and happy overall in mind, body, and spirit. So I'm gonna be touching on that as well in this video. But if you have been watching my Instagram stories and my Snap stories, you know I have recently started working out a lot more than I probably ever have in my life. And let me really quickly disclose that I'm working out because it makes me feel good, and working out actually releases endorphins, and overall my whole well-being has just I feel almost like a new person. And it's kind of this sounds dramatic, but honestly, it's changed my life. MacFit has changed my life. No, just kidding. Nope, seriously. And I will have his link to his Instagram in the description box. He's at MacFit on Instagram and Snapchat. If you guys want me to do more videos like this one, where it's just one-on-one, you and me, and keeping it real, let me know by giving this video a thumbs up, or you can comment below. I started training with Mac on December 29th. So I do cardio as well as the weight training. It's become a big part of my life now to wake up in the morning. I get up at 6:30, 7 o'clock, have my coffee, go to the gym, and it's become part of my everyday routine. And I really enjoy having a routine, so I think that's another reason why I love it so much. But whatever kind of exercise works for you and makes your body feel good, that's what I recommend you do. And you can try out different things. The workouts I do vary from things you can do just with weights, things you can do with your own body weight, and then I'll also use the machines in the gym. But my favorite kinds of workouts are the ones that you're just using with weights and your own body weight. So I'm gonna show you guys some of my favorite workouts that I do with Mac. Let's roll the footage. If the world is falling apart, give me a ring, I'll be your Katniss. After my workouts, I usually have a smoothie, and I put in one banana, strawberries, a handful of blueberries, a spoonful of peanut butter for protein, and peanut butter has a lot of good fats in it. I put in some chia seeds, I put in almond milk, and sometimes I will put in a protein powder that I get at Whole Foods just for some extra protein in there. And then I just blend that all up and drink that right after I work out. I've made this for my brother and Tila, and they both love it. I feel like an expert smoothie maker now. It's important to get those good carbohydrates and protein into your body after a workout. Moving on to diet, I haven't changed my diet much. The one thing I will say is that because of training, and I think because I drink more water, which I've been drinking a lot more water. I pee every 10 minutes. I kid you not. It's kind of annoying, but water is good for you. So stay hydrated, fam. Stay hydrated. I eat a lot of lean proteins. So I have chicken, turkey, fish. Salmon is one of my favorites. Salmon has a lot of omega-3s. It's really good for your brain. I eat eggs for protein, nuts for protein. You guys know I love my almonds. I also eat a lot of vegetables. I roast up some cauliflower and broccoli with carrots. So something I actually just started doing because of Adam, I'm gonna give him a shout out for this because I would have never discovered this. So I've started mixing spirulina. I feel like I just messed that up. Spirulina, spirulina, either one. You can see the name. I'll give you a close-up shot of this in a second. So this is just the powder, and I put in, it says take 1 teaspoon daily with or between meals. So I just put a teaspoon of this into my water every single day. I cannot tell you the difference that I have felt in just my whole body. My body feels warmer. I have more energy than coffee gives me. It boosts your energy, boosts your immunity. It supports cardiovascular health, and it supports eye and brain health, but there are so many benefits to this. Another thing I've changed in my daily routine is that I now take daily vitamin So Tila's mom actually gave these vitamins to me, and I've been taking them every single day since my birthday. So these are Andrew Lessman. I actually would hear about this all the time, and I always wanted to try them. So when I did get these, I was so excited. I take the Digest Assure, the Aloe Vera, the and the Friendly Flora, which is a probiotic. In terms of health and overall well-being, I will say that I have changed my sleeping schedule quite drastically. In 2016, I honestly did not get much sleep, and I really had an epiphany about my health this year. I think I realized that I wanted to transform not just physically, but mentally and spiritually. I think my mindset has changed a lot, and I think that's really helped me grow and learn and just continue to fuel my body and my brain. I've started going to bed so early. You guys are gonna think, I mean, I'm a grandma. I could be like, I'm not even mom anymore. I'm literally your grandma. I go to bed at 10 o'clock at the latest. Now that I'm getting all this sleep, I'm able to wake up so much earlier. Some days I wake up at 6:30, some days I wake up at 7:30, but I never really sleep in past 8 o'clock, and I love getting up early, kind of before, I feel like I'm getting up early before the rest of the city, and I just enjoy my coffee, and it's a really great feeling to like start off your day very early, and you feel like you have this whole day ahead of you to get so much done and accomplish what you want. So I really recommend trying to get a full 8 hours and just training yourself to get into that habit of falling asleep quicker. Meditating and journaling have been very important for me and just my overall well-being. I really recommend that as a stress reliever. Lastly, I just wanted to kind of talk to you guys and get kind of personal with you on this subject. So 2016 for me was a year of new experiences and a lot of growth and change. This can go for anyone that, you know, can relate or put themselves in this situation. So change is good. And you see a lot of people use that word with kind of a negative connotation, like, oh, she's changed. You can change and still be the same person. I think that everyone comes into your life for a reason, whether it's just for 5 seconds or for a month or for 3 years. They're all there to teach you something, to give you a lesson, to help you grow and learn and become who you are. The word transformation is really the word I would use to describe my change, the way I see things. My whole perspective has kind of shifted, and I'm very, very grateful for that because I see things in a different light. Not only is it so important to accept and love yourself, but we need to embrace one another. We need to let go of any resentment and not be judgmental towards those around us. And once you can get rid of all that negativity, you can live such a fuller and freer and happier life. Every day we face changes and we face personal conflicts and disappointments. And it's so important that at the end of the day, we have gratitude for the life that we live. A quote that I found that I just really love and that really resonated with me was, let me pull it up. Today I will be grateful. I will start the process of turning today's pain into tomorrow's joy. Be patient because great things do take time, and you know, in the moments you may want to rush something, but just remember patience is a virtue, and a lot of the great, you know, relationships and friendships that are formed always take time. I mean, Tila and I are a great example. We met 5 years ago, and it took 5 years for us to get very close. Great things take time. In terms of friendships, relationships, and people in your life, let people roam. I really do believe that if someone is meant to be in your life, they will eventually find their way back into it. So just let people roam. Be like a phoenix. Rise from the ashes of the past and recreate yourself. I honestly feel like I did this. I feel like the phoenix. I feel like I've recreated myself the way I think and process and see things. Love you more than the need for a certain person. And the last really important thing I learned in 2016 that I have now carried over with me to 2017 is to see people for who they are and not who you want them to be. And this is actually, this reminds me of the movie 5 Seconds of Summer, because I forget if it was the boy or the girl that just fell in love with the idea of the person. Sometimes we'll look at people with rose-colored glasses on and we don't see them for who they are. We see them for this person that we picture them to be or want them to be, and we put them on a pedestal and we don't see their flaws. We just see them as this perfect person. You have to just take the glasses off and realize this person is, this is who they are, and the only way they're going to change is through their own realization or their own, you know, will to change. Remember that darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. And that is one of my favorite quotes by Martin Luther King Jr. I wish you guys all the best in 2017. I hope it is our best year yet. I have a really good feeling about it for us, and I'm really excited to see what the future brings. I would love to hear your guys' advice and your thoughts in the comments. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already to know when I put out a brand new video. I love you, Mare Bears, and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye!